with me, I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others. Let me tell you about Senua. Her story has already come to an end, but now it begins anew.
What's happening? It's breathing. Dead. It's breathing. It's breathing. He knows she's getting closer.
He can feel her coming closer.
She's getting closer.
They're watching.
They're watching. They're watching. They're watching.
This is a journey deep into darkness. There'll be no more stories after this one.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this?
They're watching.
Why isn't she coming?
She's doing this for him.
She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
I can feel you coming.
Shh. Coming.
Quiet. Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. Well, that's not quite true. Some are old, some are new, but they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Look around you. Can you see them? Over there.
Why isn't she looking?
Why aren't you looking?
Look, up ahead. You see it too?
You promised you can.
Yes. It is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell.
Turn back. Go back. Go back. It's not safe.
What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds onto itself, growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it. There, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power. You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own, but it isn't bravery that drives her. Bravery only means something to those afraid of death. Senua's fear runs far, far deeper. looking at? What is she leaving behind? I know what she's thinking. I hear her thoughts. It's not too late to get into the boat and go back. No one will judge her. No one will ever know. There's no going back.
You can't do it.
Senua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
Use your eyes.
Use your eyes. Come on, closer.
She can't focus.
Why can't she focus?
Take a closer look, Senua.
Do not forget my story, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate, but gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea and find a road that leads north and down through deep, dark valleys. After 9 nights of riding, do not forget my story, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate, but gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea and find a road that leads north and down through deep, dark valleys. After 9 nights of riding, you will follow a great river and will find a bridge covered in gold. The path to Helheim goes from there, across the river of knives that flows from the dark world of Niflheim. Which lies the halls of hell, the place they call Helheim. There's no doubt about it.
He's lost.
source of the darkness is in Helheim. And the goddess Hela holds his soul there. Her dear beloved, Dillian.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this? Why doesn't she turn back? She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
She needs to save her soul. She wants her soul to be at the roof. She needs to lay him to rest.
He's already dead. She can save him.
There's nothing she can do.
She thinks she's going to save him.
She's not going to save him.
She'll never make it to Helheim.
She can't let him rot here. She has to try.
The bridge to Helheim. She forgets too. But she does remember that only the dead may cross it. That part wasn't so easy to forget. The old fool said there was a hidden path up to it. Let's see, shall we?
Speak of nine worlds. The world of men they call Midgard. Sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim, and that is where you must travel.
They call me Druth. Liar.
Truth is my truth.
It's good to see you again. You kept your vow.
To guide you in this life and the next. I will tell you my stories of hell if I may walk with you.
Tell me your stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
Focus. Look closer.
I can see one.
Hold it in your mind's eye. Find one like it to open the gate.
Where is the secret?
Through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it. What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It worked.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell. But I watched the Northmen. Learned their ways.
I know you did.
You listened? When everyone else laughed. My people paid a heavy price. My stories with you, and together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Another voice joins us. She once tried to make them go away, pretend they weren't real. But what good is that?
Is ruled by the giantess, Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side, and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the 9 worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead. To Hela, your Dillion was sacrificed. And with her, you must bargain.
The darkness does not bargain. It does not reason. It is rot. And now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head, the seat of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time. Battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow. Whatever the cost.
He's not breathing.
Listen to me, Senua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Surt, and the god of illusion, Van Raven. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
To Dillian.
To his soul. It won't open.
How will she get through?
Why won't it open?
Why can't
the Northmen say that in the beginning there was nothing but darkness. Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice, and the first giant was born and was named Ymir. The ice continued to drip, and the power of the void gave life to it, and it became a cow whose milk fed the giant. That's right, a cow, but you weren't expecting that. Ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valraven and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it. His sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice. Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the Old Father.
Was never really there. women will not stop her. She will find what she's looking for.
Imposter world, where the forest itself is watching.
ends with the mark of Valravan.
What does it mean?
Which ravens?
Where are they?
Can't you see them? Line up the ravens.
We picture fear, and we think of a shadow in the woods. A creature in the night. If only it were that simple. The worst kind comes without warning. A deep and primal signal from within. A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
Listen, focus. It's
This reminds her of someone.
The forest.
Where? Which forest?
The forest in the wilds.
The wilds.
She must have been.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian.
But she didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
Tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the walktrough, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated a sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry and gathered them in his mind and learned.
Some still there.
But where?
Some still there. The Raven's helping.
He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet.
Try it.
Can't think. Out in the wild. In the cold winter woods.
Where have they gone?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. Almost. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her. Think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the glow, the smallest hints of shape, sound, thought, grew in strength until they consumed her whole.
Broken. The gate is open.
Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its grip.
There's no such thing as victory. When it comes to the darkness,
like it doesn't matter.
Yet,
it will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillian before her time comes? We both see the darkness. We can fight it together.
Sister and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. When he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to Hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon? Burnt away that day. But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth, the man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these hard times.
Maybe this time there is no coming back. But then
darkness.
Senua.
And she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua. Take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
I see you! I see you now! You led me to the wilds! You trapped me there!
She won't make it.
nearly there.
Every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for truth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
I'm coming.
When she was younger, she would lay in the grass and stare at the clouds. And there she saw them. Elusive. Shifting faces. After a while, she could see the faces everywhere. The trees. The mountains. Caves.
Like I do. Once you can see into the underworld and all the souls within it will see you. Don't be afraid when they speak to you. I will always be here to guide you.
Did you see her? That was her mother, Galina. She was a priestess.
Thank you.
comes from a land older than mankind. And the Northmen call upon his flaming sword to raise their enemies to the ground. Find him, Senua, and spill his blood.